Good morning, guys. Welcome back to the channel. This is going to be the monthly Fish USA bait challenge. This is the challenge I do every month where I pick five baits off of Fish USA that I think should work for that particular month. This is obviously that month of June. Definitely getting into a summer deal for most parts of the country now, so a lot of these baits are more early summer oriented. We've got five baits. The challenge is to catch a bass, any size on each bait. Challenge would be complete. Last bait challenge in May was back in New York. Just absolutely epic. Caught fish on each one of the baits. However, there was a little debate. I did technically use two baits on one rig. I used a jig and I used my tube as the trailer. So a little controversy, but it seems like you guys were okay with that counting as a challenge complete. So appreciate the feedback on that. But today we're not gonna do that. We have all five baits on five different rods. Gotta catch a bass on each one. Let's go over them real quick. We got a little top water. This is the Berkeley Chapo. Kind of like the Whopper Plopper, just a little something different. And this is in, I think it's a shad color. Got a little pink to it. Looks real nice though. Next, we've got a Strike King Rage Bug. Got that paired on an 11/16 swing head jig head. So we're gonna be tossing that guy around. Next, we got a crankbait. That is a Lucky Craft 1.5 in the bluegill color. Next one is this big old monster. That is the good old glide bait, the Jackal Ganterelle. Last but not least, on the spinning setup, we got the Mega Bass Hazadong Shad, if I said that correctly, on a little drop shot rig. Nice little bait fish imitator. So that is the Video Fish USA Bait Challenge for the month of June. Let's get on the water, see if we can catch a bass on each one. We have 2 months in a row for challenge complete. All right, guys, we're gonna start right at the ramp. Start with a little Lucky Craft 1.5. See some nice riprap right here, so maybe we can pick a fish off. Already on. Look at that. It didn't take long at all. On the 1.5. It's a decent one. Oh man. It's a nice one. Seriously? Look at that way to start. It's probably a release fish. Oh my gosh, that's a good start right there. Look at that fish. Skinny post spawner. Well, I'd say that's a way to start the challenge. Thank you, sir. Just like the other video, I want to just keep throwing it if it's working. But I do want to keep my streak alive and catch a fish on each one. And I wanted to take advantage of the morning to get one on the top water and the crankbait, since those are gonna be more shallow baits. So next up, we're gonna go with the Berkeley Chapo. This has gotta be good for topwater fish. I mean, right next to the bank, got some bushes. Got some current, some wind. These fish should be in ambush mode. Ready to smash something on top. Come on, I'm ready to get smashed. Huh. This makes sense. Oh gosh, finally had a bite. Oh man, took me off guard. Whoops. Yeah. Big old carp just jumped in front of me. I got the Hazadong shad. That's part of the challenge. It's interesting looking. This is the green pumpkin. I got it on a weird hook though. I'm not sure if it's gonna work too well. Yeah.
Yeah, it's free and I was there.
Dang, I don't know what to do. It's killing me. Like I need to kind of commit to the top water while we still have a little bit of low light. Oh my God. Are you serious? There we go. I'm in the tree. Alrighty. Thank you, sir. Finally got one on top. Alrighty. On the Berkeley Chapo. That's two baits out of the five. It's definitely been a lot harder than I thought it'd be. Alright, we're gonna switch things up a little bit. We're actually gonna cut this off for now. This is really the only rod with, you know, heavy line on it for me that I can start flipping some of these bushes. I think that's what I'm gonna do. Try to fish it a little differently and see if we can get a bite. Peg our weight. There we go. Flip this around some of these bushes, see if it makes a difference. I actually don't know if my front camera was on for that last fish, but that was bass number three on the rage bug, structure bug. And what I was saying was sometimes it's not necessarily the bait, sometimes it's the presentation. Within the first 2 minutes of changing from that swing head football jig head to just a little Texas rig, got a bite. So now I've got the shad bait, the Megabass Hasdong shad bait on the same thing, little Texas rig, pegged weight. And we'll see if we can get one on this and get four out of the five, leaving the Ganterelle. There we go. Just looking for some fish. All right, guys, so this is not one of the baits, of course, for the challenge, but I was using it as like a search bait. Aggressive little guy. So now that we know there's at least one bass there, throw down our little shad and see if we can get one on it. Oh yeah, guess I just had to let it sit there for a while. Come on now. It's be four out of five.
You spit the bait.
Oh yeah, he swallowed that crap. We might be able to get this hook actually. Yeah, we got it, nice. That was bait number four. I'm probably saying this wrong the whole time. The Hasdong shad 4.2. And green pumpkin shad. Four out of the five baits. We just gotta get one on the Ganterelle and it will be another challenge complete. It's been tough today, so I'm happy to have that fish.
That's a good one.
Oh my God, that's a giant. Oh my lord. Holy crap. Good fish. Got a mouth on that thing. Got a head on that thing. Ramp surprise right there. Well guys, it is about 12 o'clock and I think I'm gonna call it a day. Almost completed the challenge. We got 4 out of the 5 baits today. So today this is a different part of the lake that I've actually never launched at. So I've never fished this area. I was fishing pretty much blind and just throwing at stuff that looked good. But as soon as I launched right next to the ramp where there was a bunch of rocks, and to me when I see rocks like that, especially early on in the morning, I think square bill crankbait, and that's exactly what we threw. We threw this little Lucky Craft 1.5 in the bluegill color, and that's a really nice looking color for clear water. It's got a little bit of an orange belly, but super natural looking, and I think within the first few casts we got probably big fish of the day. So after many casts, we got one to actually commit and take the Berkeley Chapo 90. I don't know if top water was the deal today, so that made it a little bit more challenging, but this was a nice bait. I really enjoy this. You know, I don't fish these style baits a ton. I have a few whopper ploppers. It seems like this is a little bit louder than the whopper plopper. I do like the finish to this. I don't know what colors whopper ploppers are, but that just has more of a natural finish than the ones that I have. Good little paint job to it. Fun little bait, so I'll definitely keep this one in the arsenal and throw it around here and there. Bait number 3 was kind of a strange one. We had to improvise a little bit. So this is the Rage Bug by Strike King. I think this is in Bama Craw, I want to say. We initially had this on one of those swing head football jigs, and I just wasn't getting bit, and I kept trying to force the issue. But what we eventually did was we ended up putting a little 1/2 ounce tungsten weight on there, pegging it, started flipping around a shallow cover, and within, you know, 2 minutes, we got a fish on it. That was bait number 3. And then our last bait that we got a bite on, our 4th bait, was the Hasdong by Megabass. That little Hasdong shad. This is in Green Pumpkin Shad. We ended up just putting on a little drop shot rig. Kind of by chance and by luck, we were dead sticking this because I was fixing my reel and one took it. So as always, all the gear that I use, including the baits, will be linked in the description. I hope you guys find these videos entertaining and useful. That's gonna do it for the video, guys. As always, thank you for watching. We'll see you later.